This Faceless YouTube channel is quietly making over $4,000 a month just from ad revenue. The creator doesn't show their face, they never speak a word on camera, and yet the checks keep coming in. At first glance, it might look like they just got lucky, or that the content is random, but I can tell you right now, it is not. I spent hours analyzing this entire channel, looking at every single video, every thumbnail, and every title they've ever posted. Once I finally cracked the code and understood the system they're using, I realized something huge. This can be completely recreated using AI, even if you have zero prior experience. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to build a faceless channel like this step by step, covering everything from the initial channel setup and the crucial warm-up phase, to designing high click rate thumbnails. I want you to pay close attention to this specific part. Their thumbnails are incredibly effective, because they are designed to spark intense curiosity. Their most viral video is already closing in on 1 million views. It starts off with a high-quality clip generated by AI, and then transitions into real images of the mysterious discoveries mentioned in the script. To figure out how they're doing this, I'm using the vidIQ extension. I just click on the three dots and hit CSV export to download all of their public channel data. By the way, I've put together a Google Doc for you in the description with all the free prompts I'm using today, so you don't have to worry about taking notes. Stick around because I'm going to show you a specific trick later that keeps viewers glued to the screen. Our friend ChatGPT is going to do all the heavy lifting for us here. I've developed a prompt that automates the analysis of every title and video from this channel just by uploading that CSV file I got from vidIQ. This gives me deep insights and data patterns that you just can't see with the naked eye. Looking at the results, the publication dates are very recent, and the AI detected that the niche is evergreen mystery. This is a gold mine, because once you have a clear niche, it's much easier to grow, attract a dedicated audience, and align your content with what the YouTube algorithm wants to promote. Most importantly, you won't have to copy anyone. You can take these successful ideas and replicate them with your own unique twist. On top of that, this prompt gave us a list of video titles so we never run out of ideas. It even gave me a content calendar with suggestions for the next 30 days. To get the ball rolling on the actual script, I'm using an extension called NextLev. I just go to one of their successful videos, click the button to extract the transcript, and copy it. This isn't for copying word for word, it's just a reference for the structure and pacing. Back in ChatGPT, I'll ask it to generate an original script in the same style as our reference. Just like that, I have a full script. I pasted it into a Google Doc and made a few small tweaks to make sure it sounds natural and conversational. Since my script is about the mysterious Voynich manuscript, I went to Wikipedia and found several images that are in the public domain, meaning I can use them in my video without any copyright issues. I just picked the best ones and downloaded them. But we want this video to look cinematic, so I'm going to use a second prompt to create custom AI images. I pasted that prompt into ChatGPT, along with my script, so the AI has the full context of the story. Then, I fed it the script in small chunks. For every chunk of text, the AI generates two specific prompts. One to create a high-quality still image, and another to animate that image using Kling AI. Before we dive into the editing, I have a little surprise for you. I've been hunting for an AI tool that is actually affordable, but still powerful enough to produce professional-grade content, and I finally found FlexClip. The best part? I'm giving away 3 free monthly business plans so you can test it out yourself. If you want to enter the giveaway, just leave a comment below telling me what kind of content you'd create with FlexClip. I'll be picking 3 winners from the comment section. Let me show you how this works. Inside FlexClip, I clicked on AI tools. You'll see 4 main categories, but I'm starting with AI text to image. You can see all the different models available, from the powerful Nano Banana Pro to OpenAI and Seedream. For this project, I'm using Seedream 4.5, which is the latest model from ByteDance. I just pasted my prompt, set the resolution to 4K, chose a 16:9 aspect ratio, and hit Generate. Once the image was ready, I clicked Image to Video. In this section, you can do text to video or add effects, but I'm focusing on animating our custom image. You can choose between Sora 2 Pro, Veo 3.1, or the newest models from Kling and Hilo. I personally went with Kling 2.6 to get that cinematic high-end look. You're free to use whichever AI you prefer, but I'm sharing these because they consistently deliver the best quality. I repeated this process for the rest of the script, generating the image prompt, creating the visual, and then animating it. There's actually another specific reason I chose FlexClip for this, and I'll reveal that in just a second. The next step is the voiceover. I copied my script, went back to FlexClip, and selected Audio, then AI Text to Speech. I was honestly impressed by how many languages are available. If you see my videos in other languages, you'll most likely find your language here. For this one, I chose US English and sampled a few voices before settling on the perfect narrator. I hit Generate, and now I have a professional sounding voiceover ready to go. Now, if you look at the channel we're modeling, they always have a subtle background track to set the mood. I used the AI music generator, typed in a prompt for the vibe I wanted, and selected the style. The AI created a great track, but it had some vocals in it. No problem. I just used the music to music feature to create a strictly instrumental version of that same song. Now, how do we put this all together? We need to edit the video. You can do the entire edit right inside FlexClip as well. I clicked Create a Video, chose my aspect ratio, and jumped into the editor. I imported all my assets and started organizing them on the timeline. I added the voiceover, which is the green part you see here, but the actual clip is the gray section. So every time I add a new clip or scene, the voiceover automatically gets enabled and plays along with it. I brought in the background music and dropped the volume way down so it doesn't overpower the narration. I spent some time refining the timing by dragging the edges of the clips to shorten or extend them. I started with the most cinematic clips to grab the viewer's attention immediately, then brought in the historical images to explain the topic. To give it more flair, I experimented with transitions and found one called Ink. Finally, I hit Export, chose the maximum 4K quality, and the video was done.
We're often told that the greatest mysteries on Earth lie beneath the ocean. But here's a far more unsettling thought. What if the real mystery isn't hidden underwater at all? What if it's been sitting right in front of us this entire time? Locked away inside a controlled archive at Yale University is a book unlike any other ever found. It doesn't belong to any known culture. It isn't written in any recognized language. And yet, it behaves like a real one. The Voynich manuscript first surfaced in the early 20th century, filled with hundreds of pages of strange illustrations, impossible plants, astronomical diagrams, and flowing symbols written in a script that has never been decoded.
Stay tuned, because next I'm going to show you the secret sauce of channel setup and how to properly warm up your account so YouTube actually shows your video to people. In that Google Doc I mentioned, I've included more free prompts to help you generate a catchy channel name. Just remember to use these prompts in the same ChatGPT conversation where you generated your script so the AI understands your channel's context. Now, pay close attention to the channel setup because this part decides how fast YouTube understands your channel and who your videos get shown to. Get this wrong, and even good videos struggle to get views. Inside YouTube Studio, I went to Customization and added the channel description that the AI generated for me. Then, I enabled the Home tab. This is the first thing people see when they click on your profile. I kept it clean, showing only the For You section, videos, playlists, and posts. You want your subscribers to find what they're looking for quickly so they can binge watch your content. Next, I went into Settings, and then the Channel section. Under Basic Info, I pasted the specific keywords the AI provided. This is vital. This is how you tell YouTube's systems exactly what your niche is. These keywords help the algorithm categorize your channel and decide which users are most likely to enjoy your videos. If these are too broad or just plain wrong, YouTube gets confused and your reach will tank. Under Advanced Settings, I marked the channel as Not Made for Kids, which is standard for this niche. You also absolutely must verify your phone number under Feature Eligibility and verify your ID to unlock advanced features. These settings directly impact how often you can upload and how much the platform trusts you. If you skip this, you're basically putting a ceiling on your growth before you even start. To give the channel some visual identity, I used the SeedReam 4.5 model in FlexClip again to create a professional banner with the exact right dimensions, along with a profile picture and a watermark. Now you're ready to hit publish, right? Not quite. First, we need to talk about the warm-up period. To be clear, warming up your channel isn't about hacking the system or tricking the algorithm, it's about validation. When you create a brand new account, YouTube doesn't know if you're a serious creator or a spam bot. Warming up your channel demonstrates human behavior and establishes your niche before you even post your first video. Imagine you just started your account today. for the first few days, don't upload anything. Instead, use the account like a regular person. Watch videos in your niche, watch them all the way through, leave genuine comments, and maybe even create a public playlist of videos you like. Subscribe to 5 or 10 of the biggest leaders in your specific niche. This sends a clear signal to YouTube. This account is interested in mystery and unexplained discoveries, meaning it gives the algorithm context. Think of it like joining a new gym. You don't walk in on day one and try to bench press 400 pounds. You walk in, you learn where the machines are, the staff gets to know your face, and you build a routine. YouTube is the same way. Once you do start posting, stay consistent, at least once a week. Now, if you want to try out FlexClip for yourself, I've put a link in the description. You can see the monthly and annual pricing on the screen if you decide to upgrade later. For the thumbnail, I've included one last prompt in the Google Doc. I recommend using the Nano Banana Pro model for this. Once you have a base image you like, click Edit and add a bright arrow and some bold text, just like the successful channel we analyzed earlier. When it looks perfect, click Export Frame, and you're done. I do want to remind you that the income figures I mentioned at the start are estimates and can vary wildly. My channel doesn't offer financial advice, and I can't guarantee specific results. Any real business takes effort, consistency, and a solid strategy. A big shout out to the creator we looked at today for proving that it's possible to make a real living with a faceless AI channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.